Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to talk about something which is being talked about by so many people, especially who are starting their career. And the topic which daunts everyone and a lot of people contemplate and think about the particular topic is whether they should learn data structures or not, and whether companies should ask data structures or not. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my take on it. That is completely my personal experience and my personal opinion. You can choose to disagree if you want to. And what I'm going to do is that in this particular video, I'll share my experiences and I'll put things in the timeline fashion so that you can click and go to the particular section. A little bit about me. I am a senior software engineer who has been working as a software engineer for last 9+ years. In fact, I think around 9.5 years now, and I think I have fair experience on various things, and I think I can give my perspective and I'm qualified enough to give my perspective on this particular topic. So there are a lot of people, in fact, most of the time, the buzz keeps on happening that some of the people are extremely against data structures and some of the people are extremely for data structures. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share first of all my story, that how things were for me back in 2014, and then I'll talk about the other experiences. So the first thing is that back in 2014, when I joined my first company, or in fact in my college, there was nobody in my college who used to practice data structures. People used to practice on paper. So that was the thing. Let's say I ask you that, hey, can you reverse the linked list? We would just write on paper a particular method. Or if somebody asks us, hey, can you reverse this word? Or can you reverse this sentence? So we could do all those things, but we were able to do on paper. So that was the max we could do. And solving on HackerRank or Codeforces, very few people in our college did. So did I. I didn't practice it much. Now, when I started my career, I could see that the people who, there were work that used to be given to us, like you have to read others' code, you have to read the code base in your projects when I joined the company, and then you had to write and contribute your code to that code base. And also you have to understand lots of things. So that is my personal opinion, that the people who are good at coding, I'm not saying you need to be red coder or all those hi-fi thing, but who are decent enough in coding, they were able to understand things better. So that is one thing I observed, that it generally reflects how you understand and how you contribute to the code base. So that was first thing I observed. And with a good company and good friends of mine, I was also able to ramp up on the data structure. So today, I am happy to say that I can solve the medium level problems easily. But that's my story. I'm not even talking about the hard problems. I'm talking about the general problems. Now, in the past, I have worked with multiple people in my previous companies as well. So there also, what I saw was that if somebody is too bad in coding, so that really reflects in the work which is assigned to them. So imagine whichever company you work for, right? Most of the times, what exactly you do? You make some database calls, make some API calls, get some data, convert a JSON to object, or you manipulate the data and then give it to somebody else. And now these data could be anything. It could be API, it could be messaging queue, lots of things, right? I mean, the things are, and the list is endless. So what you need to understand is that the bare minimum programming is absolutely needed. So as a programmer, who is starting their career, I would absolutely expect those programmer or the engineers that they would be able to convert, let's say, if I say that, hey, you will get a list, you need to convert this list to a hash map by taking a particular key, and then you need to put half of the data in one source or one destination and half in some other. So that's a bare minimum, and I would absolutely expect people, to know at least that much and not make mistake in at least the bare minimum level. So that's actually my take as well, that the, I mean, somehow I might be biased as well, but what I feel is that at least the medium level problems is something which one should know, because it helps you to think critically, and then also you don't make mistakes in the code. So let's say you write a code, you will not forget null checks, you will not forget or miss how to convert a particular data into other data. So we deal with lots of data structures here, right? We deal with lists, we deal with graphs, trees, and all those things are being used in the companies. Some of the people say that these data structures are not used. They might be unlucky, I would say, but bare minimum data structures are used. I mean, it's not no big thing to use a recursion or a tree in your code. People use it all the time, right? So if you are good at coding, you will not make mistakes. You will be faster to write code and you will be able to understand others' code better. This is something which is my take, that these medium level problems definitely helps. So that's first thing, that you are not expected to be maybe the best programmer in the world and win all the coding contests. If you do so, it's well and good, but medium level problem is something which generally helps. And I mean, what I see is that I could clearly see the people who are not able to deal with these arrays and lists and all those things. If you are able to deal with those things, so then it is fine. Now coming to my take, how things should be in general. So of course, all the extremes are not needed. Number one is, if you don't know anything, that is bad, and if you know everything, it is fine. Like, if you know, it's fine. So what is something, what exactly is my take? So my take is, first of all, let's not live in the fool's paradise. The companies which lot of fresher aspire for, those companies have lots of applicants. So since they have lots of applicants, so you need to play by the rules of the game. If they ask a particular type of problem, you need to get comfortable with that type of problem. So since many companies ask data structures, so you need to get comfortable with that. They are not going to change their pattern for you. That's one thing. The second is that, you know, many people don't know that there are a few famous companies and everyone applies for those companies. But there are other companies which are not as famous, but they still give you a very good compensation, or they give you very good learning opportunities. So if things don't align with the companies where the lots of applicants are there, you can apply to the other companies. Of course, in the today's world, it is quite possible that every companies would be flooded with lots of resumes, but in general, that's not the case. So don't just run after the big brands, because what happens is that these big brands generally have more number of options. So even if they do not need very high quality of a particular type of skill, they still raise the bar. So you can try applying various companies, but what I feel is that the medium level is something you should still aspire for and work for it. And yeah, in general, what I have seen, I have not been into the job market for very long time, but what I have seen back in 2019 when I was applying to the companies and I was able to get through as well, is that most companies do not ask too hard problem. They were generally somewhere between medium or so. So they want to hire a good talent. So I have not seen people asking a problem which nobody could solve. Maybe that would be the case now, but that was definitely not the case in 2019. People were asking the questions which were very much solvable. So the problem was not something out of the box, and the problem were not in written in a way that you could not even understand it. Nothing like that. The problems were there and you could solve it. You had to, maybe sometimes they mixed a few things, but they are definitely solvable. So I'm hoping that would be the case even now. So That's one thing that you can play. You have to play by the rules of the game, and if there are companies which have lots of applicants, you can try to apply for the companies which have lesser number of applicants, and still parallelly try to aspire for the medium level problems, and that should be good. The other thing, this is the suggestion for the people who have the power of hiring people, is that see what you require. If you require a particular skill set, if there are people who suits your skill set, so unnecessarily increasing the bar does not help anyone. It just wastes your time, and you might even lose a good candidate. And a lot of people, a lot of companies are following different other methodologies of hiring, like they give you a coding assignment, but I am not really sure about the effectiveness of those coding assignments. I mean, on paper it looks very good that you give an assignment and person will actually code, but the effectiveness of it is something which is questionable, and it really depends upon the person who is reviewing your assignment. So that's something which is still questionable. It depends upon the person who reviews your assignment, and if they do not fully understand your thing, and if they are not mature enough or experienced enough, then that process itself is questionable. So I think that was the take which I wanted to share in my channel, because this is something which a lot of people talk about, and I was talking to a few people, and I could sense what the anger as well for the people who could clearly see that the level of work which they do in their work does not match the level in their interviews. So that happens very often, but what you can do is that you play by the rule of the game. So that is something which I could suggest, or give my two cents to the talk which a lot of people do. So yeah, that's it from my side. I hope this video could give some insight to you folks. So that's it from my side. Till the next time. Bye.